Hello everybody, welcome to this Daktronics video tutorial. My name is Brian Perry. I'm the Daktronics event producer here at Iowa State. I'm going to take you through a step-by-step process of your power-up and shutdown of your video display and your control system. Now this may seem pretty easy, but things have to be turned on in a certain order for them to function properly on a game day. So I'm going to take you through that, and keep in mind the equipment that you see here is probably going to be a little different than what you see on your site since everything gets custom installed, but the steps are going to be the same. So let's go through it. First, verify your uninterruptible power supply is up and running. This UPS should constantly be on in order to keep its internal battery charged. This battery will keep your control rack up and running should you lose power, and it will allow you to properly shut down your system. Next, you'll want to turn on power to your displays. Now, power can be in a couple different places. It can be just a circuit breaker, it can be a standard light switch, or in some cases, there are rack-mounted remote power switches like you see here that will turn power to your display. So let's flip that on. Next, turn on any VIP 4400 or 4500. These are also known as video image processors. Once these are turned on, wait 2 to 3 minutes for these to boot up. These image processors take in any and all video inputs, such as a feed coming from a video switcher or a single camera feed. Now you can turn on your DMP 7000 computers. Usually there's a primary and a backup. They have a simple rocker switch that's a push and release. Once your computers are on, ensure that Sign Service is running and the world graphic is spinning on all Venus 7000 computers, including your primary and backup. DMP 7000 computers run the Venus 7000 software, which controls your VIP 4400s and drives content to your display. Next, confirm all AB interfaces are on and the proper input is selected. In most cases, one is the primary and two is the backup. Now it's time to turn on all VIP 4060s or VIP 5060s. These display image processors are taking a combined signal out to the displays. These units also take 2 to 3 minutes to properly boot up. Next, turn on all DMP 8000 computers. The 8000 computers run the VNet software and also drives content. Now, we can turn on all show control system computers. These computers usually stand alone as a touch smart or rack mounted computer. Once the computer is booted up, open Display Studio and confirm the status light is green. Turn on any and all peripheral equipment such as your Daktronics scoring and timing computer, video production systems, cameras, all sport controllers, stats computers, signal converters. All of this can be turned on at this time. Now execute any display initialization or any other necessary scripts. On your backup computers, verify that the SyncBack application is running and is properly mirroring your primary computer. Check for any working auxiliary feeds, such as an AllSport controller, cameras, DAC stats, DSDI, or any other real-time data. Messages may display at this time. Now let's check our AB interface operation by switching from the primary input, button number 1, to the backup input, button number 2. Okay, so that completes the startup process of your entire control system and your video display. Keep in mind, it's a great idea to start everything up at least 4 hours before your event to ensure everything starts up properly. Now we'll start the shutdown process. The first step in the shutdown procedure is to blank your display using a button in Display Studio. Next, go back to your remote power switch or circuit breaker and power off your display. After power to your display has been turned off, now you can turn off any signal converters. Now you can turn off all VIP 4400s or 4500s and your VIP 4060s or 5060s. Using the start menu on the computers, shut down all DMP 7000 computers and DMP 8000 computers. Close all program windows, and from the start menu, shut down all show control computers. Close all program windows on the DSDI computer, and from the start menu, shut down the computer. Now, switch off any peripheral equipment. So that concludes our tutorial on proper startup and shutdown of your control system and video display. Continue to other videos for more information on your Daktronics system.